Now we're going to draw a skeleton for our character. This skeleton is going to be used by Snapchat to move its body. The placement of the joints is very important. If you place it somewhere wrong, our character's movement will end up looking very awkward and stilted, just like my bones in real life. Thanks, Mom and Dad! We can save a lot of work by using the mirror tool. If you use the right settings, we can copy the exact layout of our left arm and use the mirrored copy as our right arm. Just remember to rename all your joints. If you stare at the front of your character, the side on your right should be called its left side, and the other way around. We are always looking at this from the perspective of our character. Here's a handy little guide from Snapchat. You can use these names for your joints, and if you name them correctly, case sensitive, Snapchat will recognize them immediately and automatically map them for you. Now that the skeleton is complete, we're going to bind our mesh to the skeleton of our robot. This will make it so that the robot's flesh will follow where the bones are going. It's a good thing that I made my robot very simple. You won't need to be very precise with weights. If you have any problems binding your mesh to the character, make sure that your objects are editable. You can do so by pressing C. I'm removing all the binded joints that his torso won't need to use. After binding your mesh, you should be able to paint weights on it using the weight tool and the weight manager. I'm flipping back and forth a lot between these windows to get the desired outcome. Important. While I was working on this character, I discovered that I've accidentally rotated his arms the wrong way. It's important that you make sure that your joints have the right orientation, or your robot is going to dance like this. To clarify, if the rotation of your joints is 0 degrees, all your joints should be pointing up. If it's pointing somewhere else, you might need to adjust a few settings, and if that doesn't work, create an entirely new joint structure. I found this out on my own, and I don't remember reading any documentation about this problem anywhere else. I managed to solve my robot's arm problems by creating some new joints. It's now ready to be uploaded to Snapchat. See you again in the next part.